Let's see, so we worked on the guillotine series last week. I didn't post that one to YouTube, so you had to be in class for that one. Sorry. But now we'll follow that up with some of my favorite ways to get into various katakatanis that we're going to work on. That's just your Garces and Brabo series. So we'll look from the same position, and it'll just give you more tools from there, whether it be you've snapped them down and got their hands on the mat, or you've sprawled them all the way down to the mat and cleared their grips on your legs. So far, so good. Trent, everyone to trim through.
Okay.
You don't mind.
Oh.
Yeah. He's got a fresh shaved head. He just looks so chill, cool, and cute. Will you put your hands on the mat and your knees on the mat, please? Maybe this angle. So a lot of the time, I'll go to my guillotine series first. I'll switch sides, raise the wrist. This is always the first one that I look for, my high elbow. But if his arm is going towards my leg here, he closes off the space for me to raise my wrist. This is pretty common. So I'll go with my pinky finger. If you guys need to move to that side, you can. It might be easier to see. So I can use my pinky finger inside his armpit and connect my gable grip here. Now I'll put my hip in to shed that grip on my leg, and then a lot of the time the first one that I'm looking for is my Olympic roll. It's one of my favorite ways to set up my Brabo, something that the Schultz brothers made pretty famous in wrestling. Okay, choking in there.
Yep.
That's why I like it, because I can start to strangle him immediately just with my grip. I'm talking to you guys normal. I'm not squeezing yet at all, right? So I have this. I can start to pinch my elbows. Now the squeeze is getting better, right, Trent?
Yep.
So now that I've cleared his elbow away from his body, I can start to step through. Use the bridge of my hips to roll Trent. My favorite way to do this is to block his tricep here. And then the one thing I don't want to see is you guys doing this. Anytime someone does this, they'll grab the wrist, and you can even get straight arm on from there. Yeah, it's a really annoying move, because you're in such a dominant position, right? So I keep everything tight, I block the tricep, and now I'm pulling my hands up so that I don't have to do that. I can start to build a wrist deep grip on my bicep, or at least like all my four or three knuckles. Right? I bring my hand on top, as close to his shoulder blade as I can, and then I pull my elbow in, right? So, I get here from this position, lock the elbow in, bring my hands up, slide my hand close so he can't grab it, and now I slowly start to squeeze and pull my elbow in, right?
Yep.
You get high for free. There you go.
You push down there. Do you ever play with push down on that quite a bit for Saki? It's like Aaron Kinsey, where you have a little push.
The thing with Aaron is if you aren't completely covering his neck, he's not going to tap. So this is nice because it does close off all those small spaces that you can find air in for blood flow in. It's a little more accurate. Because I have such a nice pose all the way around him. And then my knee on top of the leg, or on top of the elbow, is just stopping him from rotating. So it locks us into that position.
More of a block.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm just using the gable grip game. So my thumbless grip, exactly. Uno más, one more time. So I go, yeah, exactly. He's going there, I go here, I can start to sprawl out. As I sprawl, I clear that hand. I can start to really suck this arm in. My head goes in the hole, and now I switch my hips. I bridge him through. I connect here. Pull the arm as deep as I can. Now my hand comes in, and I start to get really nice double closure of the carotid artery.
I see it.
Who else wants to show?
Luke said,
I think Luke did, yeah.
No choking face on the back.
So I go pinky finger in the armpit, start to sprawl out. I start to pinch my elbows together. Don't forget that part, or else you'll kind of lose everything. And here I'm already starting to strangle it, right? The Schultz brothers would put people to sleep just with this. It was insane. Those guys are physical specimens, though. So
I'm through, bridge my hips up, catch the elbow, raise my grip, slide my hands through. So I got my head out of the way, and then I clamp down my head, and then I walk into it and start to rotate my elbow to my ribs. So these are all going to be rotational strangles. Darce or Brabo, it's all going to be, because we're rowing, right? I can engage my lat, my whole back there. Same idea, right?
There's quite a few changes.
Yeah, it just slowly gets
because everything's mechanically correct. So then whenever I start to apply that squeeze, it's I only need 10-20% tops. Then I can choke people all day. I'm not gonna be gassed after one choke, right? Everybody good there?
Yes.
Awesome. One, two.